It has this restlessness while reading and some more. Let me talk about it. It resembles sulfur. That is, it has skin problems, many skin problems. It has acrid and offensive secretions, sweat and other secretions. Yet it is cold. Unlike sulfur, it is cold. It is also introvert, like sulfur, but not so much. And it is more irritable. Let's see this. We've got a person that is more critical, more irritable, more complaining. Less satisfied from his life. Whenever he goes to read, he has this physical restlessness. He cannot sit relaxed on the chair in order to read. He's got this physical restlessness, so he cannot focus. And he's got this tendency, he's got these stomach ailments that made him eat all the time. Stomach restlessness or emptiness, although he has eaten, and he wants to eat little of this, little of that, every now and then, every while, quite often. So Rafidis is similar to sulfur, but with some differences. The same stands both for Psorinum, as we have talked about it. It is close to sulfur, but it is a more sad and progressed state, a silent sadness and more pessimistic, greatly pessimistic. Now let's go to Natrum Carbonicum. Natrum Carbonicum is very close to Natrum Muriaticum. Is a satellite constitution, and Natrum Carbonicum is like Natrum Muriaticum, that is psoric, romantic, introvert, easily offended, but keeps it inside, irritable, but keeps it inside. It's like Natrum Muriaticum, but it has some extra things. It has a sense of being estranged, a sense of estrangement from her family and from her own. A great sense of estrangement from her family and her own people. Plus, she has, like Natrum Muriaticum, she has an aversion for milk, but when it comes to Natrum Carbonicum, it is not two, it is three. Aversion milk and worse milk. The rest of it you will read it at the Materia Medica. I have to be true and to say that I only teach what I have confirmed again and again in clinical practice. I know that I haven't fully identified Natrum Carbonicum or Graphitis or other constitutions. I hope that I will do in future to come. Maybe some of them don't have anything else to be identified, but we have to teach what we have fully identified and what we have fully understood and what we have confirmed in clinical practice. Alumina. Alumina, the essence of alumina, it is a very psoric constitution, psoric 3, that is very tired physically, has dry skin and no sweating, no perspiration, 3, even if she is doing physical exercise, and she has the special kind of confusion of self-realizing. Let me explain you what do I mean by that. She says something and she feels as if someone else has said it, not she. It is not a delusion, an insanity. It is a sensation, a strange, a peculiar sensation that creates a kind of confusion as to identity, as to her identity. She sees something and feels as if she isn't the one that is seeing this thing, as if someone else has seen it. She talks, she says something, and she feels as if someone else has said it. There is an estrangement, a feeling that she is not herself, as to senses, as to the information and the function of her senses. On feeling that, she is afraid that she may become insane, fear of insanity. 2, if I don't recognize my voice, if I'm not sure that I am the one that is seeing things or hearing things, am I going crazy? So we have this psoric person that is very tired, with dry skin. All these are psoric conditions, no sweating at all, and it has this psychological special condition of confusion, as we have talked about. Tabergulin. Tabergulinum, as the essence of tabergulinum, is that we have a person that is syphilitic. And It is a person that is also irritable, very irritable, and a bit violent. And it is also always complaining and miser to feelings, to emotions, and miser generally in money. It resembles a little bit like arsenic. Sometimes it may have the history of tuberculosis, history of TB, of tuberculosis. A family history, his parents have, or his brother had tuberculosis, or he himself had tuberculosis in the past, or has had the first stage of tuberculosis. But this is not necessary. This is not the frequent case. And so, in order to have a tuberculinum constitution, we don't need this. And on the other hand, all those who had tuberculosis, or the family history of tuberculosis, doesn't mean that they have the influence of tuberculinum constitution. And that doesn't mean that we should prescribe tuberculinum. It is the same thing that I have told you about cannabis indica. When you prescribe cannabis indica remedy, that doesn't mean that he is a user of hashish. So, it is a syphilitic person. That is, he is self-centered, miser to emotions and money in relation to others, complaining, never satisfied, and then he is irritable because he wants things to be done his way, and maybe he becomes a little bit violent, and he is very rude, quite rude. If he's an individual member of the low class, as a profession and as a social status and as education, then he may be cursing, or he may behave very rudely and without any kind of politeness. He is not refined, he is unrefined concerning his manners. And he has this great aversion for cats and dogs, especially cats. He has an aversion for the hair of the cat or the dog. And so, being rude and unrefined, he may kick the cat to go, or the dog to go away. He doesn't want them in the house. He doesn't want to caress them. He touched them and he wants to drive them away. Sometimes he may have the fear that some hair will come into his tongue, into his mouth, and may swallow it. It's not an aversion of bacteria, a fear of bacteria. It's a disgusting feeling, doesn't want them and is disgust with them. Tuberculinum is very often prescribed by other homeopathic doctors, but because they prescribe according to the disease, anyone who had tuberculosis in the past or a family history of tuberculosis, they give you tuberculinum, or they prescribe according to physical symptoms. My aim is to prescribe according to the psychological profile and essence, so it is a rare constitution. Now we will describe four remedies of a group of hysterical remedies. First of all, we've got to talk about what is a hysterical, what are hysterical remedies, or what is a hysterical personality. The criteria are, we usually have many strange and changing all the time and non-typical symptoms that lack of pathology base, of pathological base. Many, strange, all the time changing, not typical, psychosomatic symptoms. I have this pain here, that pain there, and all the time these pains keep changing. This time here, that time there, and so on. And these symptoms are from stress or were stress. They are mostly appearing in front of others because it is a kind of manipulation. Once uses these symptoms and her suffering, in order to manipulate others, to do her own will, things at her own will. These symptoms may have to do with the mechanisms of spasms or contractions and constrictions. So, when you have a person that is usually spoiled, and these are usually women. Most of the time they are women. Hysteria is a female phenomenon, most of the time. This is not an accusation. The female and the male are different in nature, and so their imbalances are also different. Male men, when are imbalanced, they may get violent, or indifferent most of the times, while females tend to be hysterical or very sensitive and crying and so on, or can also become cruel. But Hysterical symptoms are mostly a female thing, or something we find in gay people, in submissive gay people, because hysterical comes from the Greek word hystera. Hystera is the womb. So it is something that has to do with the female. We may have hysterical blindness. The person sees nothing all of a sudden or after a fight with her husband, and then this lasts for some minutes or hours, and then she is well. We do all the exams, all the tests, or CT scan and so on, and we find nothing pathological. And this may not happen again, or may happen a few times again, and then everything is okay. Nothing pathological is left. The person can see 100% in the same way before and after this incident. We may have a hysterical not hearing, loss of hearing. We may have spasm of the esophagus and hysterical retching or hysterical hiccup. We may have oppression of the chest. We may have a person that cannot swallow. It has a lump here that prevents him from swallowing. And he may be able to swallow solid food, but not water. Strange, peculiar, non-typical symptoms. We may have hysterical paralysis, or paresis, or numbness of the extremities. We may have hysterical fainting, or dizziness, or vertigo. Anything you can imagine. The criteria is that apart from being strange, changing, non-typical psychosomatic without the pathological phase, it comes from stress or worse from stress. It happens mostly in front of others because it is used to manipulate others. It has to do mostly with spoiled young girls or young women that wants things to be done her own way, and so she uses this symptomatology in order to achieve her goals. Let's start with Moschus. Moschus is the most hysterical of all. Moschus. Moschus moschifeus. What is the essence of Moschus? We've got a person that is syphilitic, all hysterical constitutions are syphilitic, mostly. We've got Moschus that is very syphilitic, very spoiled, a spoiled young girl or young woman, very irritable and stubborn. And with quite many changing hysterical symptoms. And it is also very cold. So, hysterical symptoms. What are more frequent in Moschus? Hysterical blinding. Blindness, loss of hearing. Things fall from his hands, from her hands. Hysterical paralysis or paresis or numbness. Hysterical spasms or pains here and there. Hysterical fainting. Any hysterical symptom that you can name. Always changing, always not typical, always associated with manipulating. It is a spoiled young girl that has never what obedience means, what thinking of others also means. So, if they don't do what she wants, her own will, if the others don't please her, she becomes very irritable. Very irritable and very complaining. And whining all the time. And maybe great weeping. Three, you know, like a small, spoiled young girl, your young woman. She is also very cold. Cold three. This is Moscow. The essence and main psychological characteristics and profile of Moscus. Then we go on with Lilium Tigrinum. The essence of Lilium Tigrinum is that it is a syphilitic hysterical constitution that is never satisfied. She keeps complaining all the time. She is never satisfied, although all things are okay, are more than okay. She has money, she has a good job, she has children. Her children are good, her husband is okay, but she is never satisfied. She is always having this feeling that things are not well, that these things are not satisfying. And she complains all the time. And she is so unsatisfied. This is the essence. Let's explain it more. Unsatisfied. All the time unsatisfied, although things may be okay, but she keeps complaining. And she becomes irritable. But not so much as Moscus. And she is very irritable when she doesn't want others to talk to her. Because she gets angry when they talk to her, or even more when they consolate her. She wants to be left alone, but she keeps complaining. And when someone keeps complaining, others tend to tell her, "You're not right. all things are okay, why are you complaining? That's worse consolation. She is worse the type of consolation that others tell him, you are not right. You keep complaining while things are okay. Why do you complain? Why are you not satisfied? Then this kind of consolation makes her very angry. She may have many hysterical symptoms. Like fainting, dizziness. She tells you that I've got this dizziness and I am afraid to go out alone. When someone accompanies her, then she's okay. She is afraid that she may fall on the street, and she's not so much afraid that she will hit her head and get injured. She is afraid of the embarrassment she will feel to others, that they will see her fall down and hit and get hurt. Does not go out alone. Many hysterical symptoms. And unlike Moschus, she is hot, two or three, and she's got many, she's got palpitation quite often. This is Lilium Digrimum. Unsatisfied and complaining all the time, although things are okay. You shouldn't give Lilium Digrimum to people that have real problems, great problems, and they complain about it. But when they don't have problems, when their problems are solved, they are okay. We talk about a person that is hysterical and complaining all the time, although things are not so. I'm not so bad. Asafoetida. Asafoetida essence is that we have a mild hysterical person, more mild than Moschus or Lilium Digrinum, that has its hysterical symptoms are mostly on a lump to the throat. She's got this got many hysterical symptoms, not so many as Moschus, yet the main one is at the, she's got this lump on the throat, this hysterical spasm that makes her feel that she cannot drink or eat. And while trying to drink or eat, she chokes and she takes it out. She feels that this lump comes from the stomach up to the neck. It is an internal spasm and lump. It is not like another hysterical remedy, cactus. Cactus feels as if a hand is choking him from outside to inside, while Asafoetida the opposite, it has a lump inside the throat that prevents eating or drinking. So she feels that lump coming from the stomach to the throat, and she wants to drink or eat, and she is choking. So she wants all the time to drink a little bit of water in order to drive this lump, this blockage away. And she feels burning in on the esophagus and feels dryness, and she tries to swallow all the time in order to drive the blockage away. And she's got this hysterical hiccough in order to throw this thing outside, or retching, or gases. So you see, they are trying to go up and they are trying to go down. As her name reveals, she's got offensive secretions. Fetid, offensive secretions. And last, we go to simis effuga. Simis effuga, or a synonym is Actea racemosa. Simis effuga or Actea racemosa, it's the same thing. The essence of simis effuga is that we have, as Kent says, a hysterical rheumatic constitution. Women that are both hysterical and rheumatic. We've got hysterical symptoms, not so many as Moscus, lighter ones, and we've got many rheumatic conditions, problems of the joints and bones, and she's very sensitive to cold, weather changes, and so on. As you have seen, when we have talked about frequent and wide and basic constitutions, we have been talking for hours. They had too many characteristic symptoms and character, they had many characteristics. Their symptoms were very characteristic, and we had a full picture, a full psychological picture, and many general physical characteristics. But when we talk about less frequent constitutions, things are very narrow and things are less intense and less characteristic. We've got partial information from the psychological sphere and the physical sphere. Maybe this is because of their nature, but maybe this is because I and we, other homeopathic doctors, haven't been able to have the right information from provings and from clinical practice. We must always be open in order to complete their picture and fully identify them. But before this it is done, or if it is never done, we should only use them when there is similarity. And first of all, we should try to choose and prescribe constitutions that are very basic and very rich and characteristic in symptoms, and not focus on one symptom and give a less frequent remedy. Thank you.